Hello, Scottish Gran here. 3rd of February 1959, it was called the day the music died. And of course, I think we all know the story. Buddy Holly, Big Bopper Richardson and young Richard Valens, of course, died in a plane crash along with a pilot. People giving up seats for others so that they could help them out, because I know that the Big Bopper apparently was ill, and I think Richard Valens said he'd never won anything like that in his life. Fate played a real hand there. I think we can agree how influential Buddy Holly was. He was 22 when he died, and by that time he was starting to change the face of music, because he wasn't only writing his own stuff by that time, he was also starting to produce as well. As I say, it's almost legend now. And I think it's been said, and we're going to keep saying it, that I think he changed the face of music and really paved the way for others. It was maybe the day the music died, but it was also, in a way, the music was born in a strange way, wasn't it? So we're going to honour that, and of course it has to be Buddy Holly, and it has to be, for me, Everyday.
Every day, it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Every day, it's a getting faster. Everyone said, go ahead and ask her. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey. Seems a little longer every way, love's a little stronger, come what may. Do you ever long for true love from me? Every day it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey. A little longer every way, love's a little stronger, come what may. Do you ever long for true love from me? Every day it's a getting closer, going faster than a roller coaster. Love like yours will surely come my way. Hey, hey, hey. Love like yours will surely come my way.
Buddy Holly and the Crickets. I think I could have picked Not Fade Away, Oh Boy. I mean, they're all there, aren't they? As I say, 3rd of February 1959. And we owe him such a debt. Of course, I understood by reading somewhere that beat in the background was one of the musicians actually slapping his leg and giving us that beat. And we hear it now. I'm going to say we hear Wren, you know, giving the beat that doesn't come from drums or anything like that. Maybe that's where it comes from. Maybe that his music's actually still so influential. Great stuff anyway, isn't it? But as always, if you've got thoughts on Buddy Holly, please comment down below, let me know what you think, and of course always what you're listening to, because I'm always happy to listen.